Welcome to another food adventure with Getting Lost. We are back. We are back at ABC Brickworks to eat food. Western food like this. Or food from across the crossway in Penang like this. Or surprisingly good noodle dish. A new invention that I haven't eaten before. And some soup. So join me at ABC Brickworks Food Center. We have been here before. We are coming here again to eat more food because you can never finish all the good food at a good place. So join me as we eat more food. Let's get going and let's get eating. We are back along Jalan Bukit Merah to visit ABC Brickworks Food Center over here. Previously, we've been here before. We've been here twice. I'll put the link in the description below on how to get here. Or you can also click on the link to see what the foods we ate here previously. But this is ABC Brickworks and there's lots of good food here. And let's go down and let's eat some. But before that, we had to cross the road. Yes, ABC Brickworks. It's named after a brickworks factory here. No, not it's here. Further up the road, at the crossroad there, there used to be a bricks factory. First up, let's go to this shop here called Jason Penang Cuisine. They make a few dishes here from Penang, but the one we're gonna try from here is their Penang Laksa, or more commonly known Asam Laksa. Here's the dish itself. Okay, you have a bowl of noodles, which is rice noodles, and then you have a broth made of seafood, means mostly sardines. Then you put inside there onions, cucumber, lettuce, okay, and then pineapple, and then on top of that you put in your preserved shrimp paste, which is gooey, sweet, and flavorful. And then also some cut chilies. These cut chilies are a bit spicy, so be careful. Here, the dish here, overall, is quite nice. It's sour. If you like sour, this is a dish for you. There's a nice crunch when you bite into the vegetables. And then also when you bite into the pineapple here, you get also another bite of sweetness. Overall, this dish here is quite tasty. It cost me $3. It's quite nice and sour. If you like a sour dish, you're craving for something sour, this is a dish for you. But I felt that the soup itself is a bit too diluted, not have enough flavor. And if you are from Penang, I suggest you do not try this dish. Next up, we are here at Yong Ki famous fish ball noodles to eat their fish ball noodles. So I ordered a bowl, $3. If you do not state the price, they will give you the $4 portion. Here is the $3 portion itself. It's a bit small. Here is the dish itself. The first thing you notice is you can actually smell the vinegar from this. And they actually do the noodles here very well. The noodles here is almost al dente, nice firm texture, very nice to bite into it. And then they also have some fish ball. The fish ball texture is also not too bad, but what I really like here is the fish dumpling. The fish dumpling here, when you bite into it, you can taste that there's more than just flour in it. Overall, all the ingredients here are good, but what really stands out is the noodles. The noodles, they actually do it very well here. The texture, the bite of the noodles, excellent. So if you do like your noodles nice, with a nice firm bouncy, nice firm texture, with a good bite to it, this is the noodle dish for you. We are now in line for this shop here called Ar'er Soup. Ar'er Soup actually makes traditional Chinese soups for sale, and here are the prices. The prices are actually quite reasonable. And this shop is actually mentioned in the Michelin guide under the Big Gourmand section. So what happens is they open for two timings, lunch and dinner. So once they open for lunch, they will keep selling the soup until they sold out. Then they close the shop and they open it up again for dinner. And during dinner time, they will sell the soup until they sold out again. This is the dish itself. I actually ordered lotus root soup, lotus root with pork rib soup. And that cost me $4, and then the pumpkin rice cost me 80 cents. Unfortunately, the pumpkin rice itself, I didn't really like it. It was a bit mushy and didn't really have much taste to it. But the soup, on the other hand, had all the taste. The soup itself was flavorful, lots of porky flavor, and you can also taste the lotus root inside the soup itself. And the meat has been cooked for such a long time that all the cartilage is now soft, so you can actually just munch on it easily and tenderly. The only problem I have is there's not enough peanut taste to the soup. Other than that, the soup itself is delicious. The soup itself is super yummy to the last drop. So besides eating the soup there, I also took away home two other versions of the soup. So if you do take away, they charge you an extra 20 cents for the container. Okay, so the two soups I actually ordered was the first one, all cucumber soup, which is a popular soup. Next one is the Buddha jump over the wall. Okay, so Buddha jump over the wall is actually a very luxurious soup that you normally get at high-end Chinese restaurants. Okay, here over here is the lotus old cucumber soup. As you can see, this is the old cucumber, and the pork rib pieces here are also cooked until they are nice and tender, that you can just chew all the cartilage, everything through. One thing I must say, somehow the old cucumber, the flavor goes very well with the porkiness of the soup. So I feel of the three soups I've taken, the old cucumber soup is the most tasty of all the soups, because somehow the combination goes very well together. Okay, now I'm going to try the Buddha jump over the wall. Oh yeah, the old cucumber soup cost me $3.50. The Buddha jump over the wall, $6.50. Okay, so here's the soup itself. Of course, this soup itself is you have the ingredients like mushroom, fish maw, chicken. Okay, you won't have goji berries and also parsley. Okay, and then look at that. These are pieces of chicken. The difference here is that is this piece here, which is the abalone. If you eat at a high class restaurant, you have a big piece of abalone, and the abalone actually adds in a lot of seafood, a lot of abalone taste into the soup, which is actually missing from this soup. Other than that, this soup itself is still very good, still very delicious, done very, very well. Just that it doesn't have the luxurious feel, but it's still very affordable and it's still delicious. Next up is this place called Bao Zhai. Basically, they sell freshly made dim sum items and dumplings and baos, which is steam buns. Okay, so I actually bought some of the steam buns here. Okay, the first thing is the char siu bao or barbecue pork bao. One thing I don't really like is the size of this bao is actually a bit small. It is small. It is a bit pathetic. It's like if I combine three of the bao, I can make a normal size bao. So I do not like it when they actually make the bao so small. You can barely taste anything. I like the feeling, and I like that they actually constantly are making the baos at the shop itself. So you always have a fresh batch of baos and dim sum to eat. But I do not like that it's so small. This is the glutinous rice, which is actually quite tasty. I actually quite like the texture of the glutinous rice. I quite like the texture of the glutinous rice. It has a very nice firm mouthfeel to it, which is quite tasty. Other than that, this is the only thing that I enjoyed. The bao itself I felt was a bit wasteful, a bit pathetic, a bit small, a bit you shouldn't waste your time buying it. Next up is this shop called Lusa and Tara, where they actually have an interesting dish here that I haven't tried before, which is called lontong curry. Lontong is a type of a Malay dish. Normally you have it in soup. Curry means dry, so it's lontong dry style. Here it is. It reminds me a bit of nasi sambal goreng without the rice. So you have lots and lots of stuff here. You have bergedil, which is a potato croquet, and then you have chicken wing, then you have nice sambal here. Okay, and then you also have a lontong, which is a rice cake cut into a few pieces, and then you also have like a coconut thing on top of it, fried coconut, and then you also have a sambal goreng, which is like tofu and a few other ingredients with tempeh cooked together. Overall, this is a super flavorful dish. The chicken itself is still warm and still crunchy, and then everything goes very well together. It's just a very interesting and delicious dish, and if you are here, you should drop by and try this interesting creation. Finally, I'm here at Wild Wild West. They actually sell Western food. I actually ordered the chicken cutlet set, which cost me $7, and I add an additional pork cheese sausage, which cost me an additional $3. So here's my meal itself. It looks impressive and it is delicious. Yes. You have a deep fried goodness of first you have baked beans, and then you have a coleslaw that's actually quite good. Then you have fries, and here is the pork cheese sausage. And then you have a chicken cutlet topped with a mayonnaise sauce. I think it's a tartar sauce. Somehow the combination here with a nicely fried chicken cutlet, which is crispy and still tender inside, and then you have the flavorful pork cheese pork sausage which is a good sausage. When you bite into it, there's still a nice sausage bite to it, you know, where the thing, you know, there's a nice sausage feel to it. The fries are good, the coleslaw is good. Nothing about this dish is bad. I really really love this Western food dish, and watching this now is making me hungry again for this. This is really really delicious. This is ABC Brickworks Food Center. And we have made our mark here. We have eaten lots of food here. And the food here is good. So, there's still lots more to try. I hope you'll come down. I hope you make this place one of your regular places to come and visit, because the food here is good. Now, I hope you enjoyed the food adventure here. I surely did. There's lots of good food here, which I've eaten. And what I need you to do now is I need you to like, share and subscribe. And don't forget to join me for my next food adventure. Bye bye.